Good morning to all students. So today we will discuss about diabetes mellitus part 4. So in the last lectures we have discussed about the definition of diabetes, then classification. Then in the last lecture we have discussed about the etiological classification of diabetes mellitus. Now in today's lecture we are going to discuss about type 1 diabetes mellitus part 4. So let's continue with our lecture part 4, diabetes mellitus. The topic of today's lecture is type 1 diabetes mellitus. Type 1 diabetes mellitus. Now, type 1 diabetes mellitus, it is also formally called as insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. Insulin dependent diabetes mellitus or juvenile diabetes. Type 1 diabetes mellitus is characterized by low or absent level of endogenously produced insulin and by dependence on exogenous insulin. Type 1 diabetes mellitus mein kya hota hai? By insulin level is low, is reduced by low ya complete absence of endogenously produced insulin and dependence on exogenous insulin, outside insulin, to prevent development of the ketoacidosis. An acute life-threatening complication of type 1 diabetes mellitus. So what we have discussed, that type 1 DM, it is characterized by low. या तो कम होगा या absent level of endogenously produced insulin and dependence on the exogenous insulin. क्यों? To prevent development of ketoacidosis. And ketoacidosis is a life-threatening, it's an acute life-threatening complication of type 1 diabetes mellitus. Now basically what is ketoacidosis? Diabetic ketoacidosis. It's a buildup of the acids in the blood. ये कब होता है? When the blood sugar is too high for too long. Blood sugar level से बहुत ज़्यादा होता है, बहुत high होता है, बहुत लंबे time तक. Then it happens. It is life threatening. Of course, it's a life threatening complication. इसमें क्या होता है? It occurs basically when blood doesn't has enough insulin, right? So ketoacidosis is a life threatening complication of the type 1 diabetes mellitus. Now the onset predominantly occurs in the childhood with a median age of 7 to 15 years. Is age group mein sabse zyada common hota hai ye. But it may present at any age. Baki kisi bhi age mein ho sakta hai, but mainly predominantly is age group mein hota hai. 7 se 15 saal ki age group mein hota hai. And most prominently it is common in childhood. Type 1 diabetes mellitus is characterized by autoimmune destruction of the beta cells. ये हम हर लेक्चर में पढ़ चुके हैं कि type 1 diabetes mellitus occurs due to autoimmune destruction of the beta cells. It is characterized by autoimmune destruction of the pancreatic islet beta cells. Both genetic susceptibility and environmental factors contribute to the pathogenesis. Genetic factors, genetic susceptibility and environmental factors, they are responsible for the development of type 1 diabetes mellitus. They contribute to the pathogenesis of type 1 DM. Susceptibility to type 1 diabetes mellitus is genetically controlled by the alleles. Susceptibility to type 1 DM is genetically controlled by alleles. Now what is alleles? It's a variant form of the genes. Some genes, the genes hote hai na, allele is a variant form of the gene. Some genes have variety of different forms which are located at same position. Kuch genes ke different different forms hote hain, they have variety of forms which are located at the same position and or genetic locus kehte hain isko, or genetic locus on the chromosome. Humans are called diploid organisms because they have two alleles at each genetic locus with one allele inherited and from each parent. Now it's clear what is allele. So what is allele? Allele is a variant form of the gene and some genes they have different variety of forms. They have variety of different forms which are located at the same position. Isko hum bolte hain genetic locus or genetic locus on the chromosome. Humans ke andar kya hote hain? Humans are called diploid organisms kyunki inke andar do alleles hote hain at each genetic locus. Humans ke andar do alleles hote hain at each genetic locus with one allele inherited from each parent. Do alleles hote hain with one allele inherited from each parent. So susceptibility to type 1 diabetes mellitus is genetically controlled by the alleles of the major histocompatibility complex. Now histocompatibility complex, gene, it provides instruction for making a group of related proteins known as the human leukocyte antigen complex. So susceptibility to type 1 DM is genetically controlled by alleles of the major histocompatibility complex. Histocompatibility complex, it is a group which provides instructions for making a group of related proteins known as the human leukocyte antigen complex. Of the major histocompatibility complex class 2 gene expressing human leukocyte antigens. Aur jo human leukocyte antigen hote hain, kya karta hai? It helps the immune system distinguish the body's own proteins from proteins which are made by the foreign invaders such as virus and bacteria. अभी हमने क्या बात करी? Histocompatibility complex. So histocompatibility complex क्या करता है? ये instructions देता है for making a group of related proteins known as human leukocyte antigen. और जो human leukocyte antigen होता है, ये क्या करता है? Immune system को help करता है, support करता है to distinguish, to differentiate between the proteins which are made by the body from the proteins which are made by the foreign invaders, such as bacteria and virus. मतलब ये जो होता है human leukocyte antigen, ये इम्यून सिस्टम को हेल्प करता है ताकि वो डिफरेंशिएट कर पाए उन प्रोटीन्स के बीच में जो कि बॉडी बनाता है और वो प्रोटीन्स व्हिच आर मेड बाय द वायरस एंड द बैक्टीरिया. ह्यूमन ल्यूकोसाइट एंटीजन इज अ ह्यूमन वर्जन ऑफ द मेजर हिस्टोकंपैटिबिलिटी कॉम्प्लेक्स, अ जीन ग्रुप दैट अकर्स इन मेनी, इट्स अ ग्रुप ऑफ जीन्स व्हिच अकर इन मेनी स्पीसीज. ये जो ह्यूमंस के अंदर जो होता है ना, ये HLA human leukocyte antigen या जो histocompatibility complex होता है, consists of more than 200 genes located close together on chromosome number 6. Autoantibodies to beta cell antigen including the islet cell cytoplasm, insulin autoantibody, glutamic acid, decarboxylase, islet antigen 2 and zinc transporter 8 are detected in the serum from affected subjects. Autoantibodies to beta cell antigens including the islet cell cytoplasm, insulin autoantibody, glutamic acid, decarboxylase, islet antigen 2 and zinc transporter 8, they are detected in the serum from affected subjects. These can be found months to years prior to clinical onset of type 1 diabetes mellitus. Jo humne baat kari last slide mein, ye autoantibodies to beta cell antigens including islet cell cytoplasm, insulin autoantibody, glutamic acid, decarboxylase, islet antigen 2, zinc transporter, जो हमको मिलते हैं सीरम के अंदर from the infected subject, from the affected subjects, हमें मिलते हैं, they can be found, they can be detected months to years, मतलब type 1 diabetes mellitus diagnosed भी नहीं होगा, developed भी नहीं होगा, उससे पहले ही हमको months to years ये मिल जाते हैं, पहले they can be found months to years prior to clinical onset of the type 1 diabetes mellitus. In some children and adolescents with apparent type 1 diabetes mellitus, the beta cell destruction is not immune mediated. Kuch bachchon mein, kuch adolescents mein, beta cell destruction is not immune mediated. It can be idiopathic. This subtype of diabetes occurs in patients of African or Asian origin and is distinct from known causes of beta cell destruction, such as drugs or chemicals, viruses, mitochondrial gene defects, pancreatectomy and ionizing radiation. These individuals may have ketoacidosis. Agar jinme type 1 diabetes mellitus hai, to ketoacidosis is the most common life-threatening acute complication of type 1 DM. So these individuals may have ketoacidosis, but they have extensive periods of remission with variable insulin deficiency, similar to patients with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Patients with type 1 diabetes mellitus, they require lifelong treatment with insulin. Jin patients mein type 1 diabetes mellitus hai, they will require lifelong treatment with insulin. Thank you. With this, we complete with our lecture of today, type 1 diabetes mellitus. Thank you.